we decided to go to Mika, Canada to interview Aaron, the head of marketing, about the summer's new trends.
You know, for this summer coming, your pinks and browns together, yeah. Your blacks and hot pinks together, anything dark with fluorescent colors as an accent color is yeah. definite. I don't know if you remember the old Kemper snowboard suit, yeah, but it was like turquoise, pink, yeah. and fluorescent yellow all matched into one. Well, now they're going with a black or, you know, a white with an accent fluorescent color. And, you know, I think a lot of that was inspired from the one Oakley goggle that came out last winter. I think it was the hot pink Oakley goggle.
Our next stop is Surf Paradise, a local skate shop.
People just wear whatever they want to wear. I mean, everybody has their own idea of what's cool, and they just kind of dress accordingly, and you know, I think that's how it should be.
Yeah.
You know, there's still like different types of like social cliques that everybody kind of, where you can kind of see people dress the same, but yeah, everybody just has their own thing, and then they go from there. You know, whatever kids see on Much Music or yeah. see in magazines or exactly. see the cool guy's school wearing is what they want to look like, and then it's everything from friggin' pink shoelaces to bohawks to, I don't know, old school Nikes and Volcom t-shirts and whatever.
Do you think it has a lot to do with media, like, especially like skateboarding, biking and stuff like that? If you see a really good rider that impresses you, you think maybe if you look up to him, you'd be interested in dressing similar?
Well, that's the whole idea. Any clothing company or any shoe company, that's the whole reason why they you know, make advertisements or sponsor certain athletes is because they feel that those athletes can represent the image they want to portray to the public, and basically it comes down to putting their sales up. That's what it's all about. I know people are willing to pay a lot for shoes. I mean, some of the shoes we have in here, I would never come in here and buy them, you know, but like, that's why, you know, DC and Circa, shoe companies like that, have pro athletes like, you know, Dave Mira and Dan Way and Chad Muska and you know, why Nike sponsors famous basketball players that make cameos in rap videos, you know? That's yeah. it right there. People are willing to pay that money to look like the cool guy.
Do you think Bracebridge, like, caters to, like, these things? Like, do you think, like, other than surf, there's a lot of stores to buy this type of style and clothes?
No, not at all. I mean, the majority of people here still do probably half their shopping down the Barrie or down in Toronto.
Yeah.
That's just where they feel they can get the new stuff that they didn't see the commercial for or whatever.
So that kind of goes back to willing to pay anything, right? Like, they're gonna they'll pay for gas money to go there and for food.
And a lot of it has to do with, you know, skateboarders and bikers and the alternative kind of people like that. You know, they like to look like what they do. Focus. Commitment and trust given to me. Friendship. Forced to Outdoor trends, all kinds. Adventure sports are huge right now. Certainly adventure racing influences a lot of the way the technical clothing is being built. Running shoes, right down to your underwear, everything is becoming lighter, faster, and it's that much more useful for all kinds of activities. I think so. I think the Brace Brigeria certainly would, the people that come through here, certainly the local crew as well as, I guess this is the summer crew. I think any area is really susceptible to trends and what's happening and what's new. And, everybody wants to be on the is there more room for more outdoor technical clothing? Absolutely. I mean, always healthy competition is always a good thing.
I just wanted to know what you think of like trends today, like when you see teenagers and people just walking down the street, what do you think of how they dress and notice any type of trends like becoming more popular, things like that?
What I like to see, what really struck me a few years ago, comparison to when I was a youth, was the looseness of clothing. You look around, look at your pants today. Look at the pants they underneath are real baggy. It's very healthy, good quality too. Sneakers in my day were uncomfortable. But today we have sneakers that are phenomenal, really cushioned, really designed for the stepping, you know. Yeah, shorts are baggy, you know, t-shirts are styles. Not so much style trend, like you really want to look like a part of everything, but it's just all there for you now. You just have a lot of healthy stuff, a lot of light stuff, a lot of loose clothing. It's good for kids, yeah. But I'm like 51. If I did, I'd wear like what you guys wear. See, your jacket is just great. Shout out jacket. That jacket is just awesome. See, see how nicely you dress. You got your black and white sneakers on, right? They're nice. See, your dark gray pants go with your light gray and black jacket. That's what's there today. You know, it's all blended. I like caps now. It's the way the guys wear them. And the colors and quality are really good. You see nice caps. You know, border, rounded brims and different colors. And girls and guys wearing their pinks and their blues. And you know, they're really good to see. And they're fun. You know, some guys, you just feel like wearing it this way or that way or this way or over here. And they're really fun.
This is the cap you want to get, Mark. But we'll talk about that later. How's that, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Sometimes you wear them like this. Sometimes you wear them like this. Sometimes you wear them like that. Or sometimes you wear them like that, right? But they're all great kids. I've had this cap, this hat, for 14 years. At least 20 times a winter, I get comments on this hat. Boy, is that a nice hat. It's a nice hat. And I always laugh at myself. You know, I went into the Salvation Army store, you got this. And I bought this cap for 50 cents. 50 cents. Everybody's, boy, what a nice hat. I really like that. Because it's good this way, when it's about zero weather. You can keep my head nice and warm in the wintertime. But then when you get down to about 10, 15 below and I have to walk, this is the best about it. See? Covers the ears, boy. Covers the ears. Hey, goddamn market, boy.
Yeah.
Hey. Right in on Goshen Skull. Yay! It's a great hat. Everybody says, last year, I'm telling you, at least 15 people, last one, boy, I like that hat. It's a good hat record. I always laugh. 50 cents. I wish not. Can't beat that one. It's from the Lord, right? Oh, got that one, honey.
All right.
I don't like it when people look the same. You know, like all them wiggers. They all look the same, wear the same stuff. People should be individuals. Have their own individual style.
Like the long hair look?
Yeah, man, that's my style.
The belt?
Yeah.
Do you feel school dress codes are appropriate?
Yeah, well, I don't know. People should be allowed to wear what they want, as long as it's not offending anyone.
But what do you think about, like, muscle shirts on guys? Do you think that offends you? Have you seen another man wearing a muscle shirt?
Oh, yeah, I'm totally offended.
What about boxers sticking out of their pants? You know, a lot of cool guys, they love to have the boxers. You know, the pants down around the knees?
I think if they want to look like idiots, then they can look like idiots.
Do you think, like, celebrities kind of made these star trends because they're so popular and so looked up to? Do you think it's easier for them to bring a style in?
Yeah, there's all those, like, celebrities with their own clothing line and stuff.
Hey, this is my sweatshirt. I'm not allowed to wear this to the class because it shows a little nip right there. That offends some people, I guess. And I got sent to the office today and I'm not allowed to wear it anymore.
Can you see the back? It's bigger.
You can see the back.
No, but I guess they're alright. It keeps girls from dressing improper. And guys from dressing improper too. No, I don't like watching guys that are freaking nasty.
Do you think celebrities affect how people dress, like the media and stuff?
Girls, especially. And guys that are at school because they dress, thugged out. And girls dress hustling. It's gross.
She's alright, I guess. Do you think it's celebrities that mainly start trends? Just because they're kind of looked up to and stuff?
No, I don't think so. I think trends start like in microcosms. Microcosm is like a little part of like our little piece of the world, you know? Right. Like, say everybody started dressing like from the 80s around here, nobody else did. Everybody do it around here. You know, right. It's not caused by it. They don't dress up like celebrities. Like, nobody wearing Gucci or anything like that around here. Right. I don't think.
Yeah.